Well, hello, friends and neighbors. This is Zach with Burgess Auctions. Just wanted to pause and visit with you a moment about the Phyllis Kingen auction. It is closing now. The pickup is scheduled for tomorrow from 9 o'clock till 5 o'clock at 45 West Carey Street in Knightstown. We're running through the antique furniture right now, and looks like things are selling pretty well, and we appreciate each and every one of your participation. We will be here from 9 to 5 tomorrow for local pickups. We do ship. We do all of our shipping from in-house. So if you need shipping, just simply send us an email request. We'll get you in the shipping line and should have you a shipping quote within by the end of the week. We do all of our shipping in-house, so we try to keep the prices as reasonable as we can. You will receive a – go ahead and pay your invoice if you are a winning bidder and need shipping. You'll receive a invoice in your email. Go ahead and pay that. Send us a shipping request, and then you'll get another separate shipping invoice from a company called Shipping Saint. And once you get that paid, after we get everything packed and weighed up, we will get it. Get you a quote. We have 105 users online right now. You know, Phyllis came to many of our auctions for many years. We sold her some of these primitives and stoneware and things over the years. She was a great farm wife, the matriarch of the Kingen family in western Hancock County out of McCordsville. You know, she was always a gracious host. Don, of course, was a Minneapolis Moline collector. She liked her blue on white pottery and farm primitives and things. And she was just a neat old, neat lady, very active, 4-H and in the church and the quilt guild and things like that. So we just appreciate each and every one of you being here, participating in the auction, and we're going to watch it kind of go. Guys, this whole step back cupboard, I'll tell you, that thing is dovetailed. The top and bottom, the dovetails match. It's put together with old wooden square nails. There is a dandy old walnut two-piece step back cupboard. And right now, the leading the race is Ohio. So we have a bidder from Ohio leading the race on that old blind door step back cupboard. The blue on white, the enamel, the stoneware, it's really just a remarkable collection. I see some Lloyd Fuquay's coming up. You know, he was from Fortville, lived out there on 238. When I was a boy, we would go over there with Boy Scouts and things, and he takes out there in the log cabin. You know, Lloyd was a we used to go hang out with his brother, Lester. Dad would always take me over to see Mr. Fuquay, and he liked Model Ts and tinkering out there in the garage, and I could never wait to go see Mr. Fuquay, and that was always like the highlight of our days when we got to go see Mr. Fuquay, either one of them. And then Joe lives just down the road. He was a neat guy to go visit with too. So I remember we went over there one time and Uncle Bob went with us, and Lloyd showed him a wooden chain he had carved, and you know, that fascinated my Uncle Bob, and he had to go carve him a chain. So I know where there is a Lloyd Fuquay chain, but I can't get my hands on it. So we did an auction last year for Mr. Doty, and he had one hanging on his wall. And yeah. So anyway, we just appreciate your participation in the auction, and we hope to see each and every one of you tomorrow at pickup. some flow blue coming up. That D. Laval cutout metal cow. I think you mailed that in, and they'd mail you a catalog or send you some more information or something. It's pretty cool. It's a neat piece. So, got some wool coming. That one in the middle looks an awful lot like a one fuquay too. It's just not signed. I've never seen any of his work that wasn't signed, but I guess it's possible. So, yeah, there's some ooh and stoneware, some blue on white coming, some enamelware. You got some great books and things coming your way. That's a pretty neat old co-op apron. I know when we told Joe Fuquay's, Richard told me he collected Lloyd carvings. I know there's several other people who want to do, but he was a neat old guy. I'll tell you. Be some cast iron coming up in the auction. A lot of stoneware, a lot of blue on white, some frozen Charlotte dolls. We've got some Indiana art, Rosemary Lawton Thomas, and some Elizabeth Hines. Elizabeth Hines was out of Philadelphia, Indiana, and her husband was a Minneapolis moline dealer. That's what Kathy told me. So I got some cowboy coffee pot coming. I think Gene Stratton Porter will be coming up for long. This is the first session of Phyllis's collection. We went and picked up a whole truckload of stuff and went back about a week or 10 days later and picked up everything out of the barn. So there's some yard art coming in that auction. And then the family had went through the basement and called us, and we went and picked up another truckload. So it'll be a few weeks, but there'll be some more of Phyllis Kingen's auction coming your way. Some great flow blue, bisque baby dolls, lots of country decor. I know there's some Michael Bonney copper, some Mary Hadley pottery coming. So a lot of interesting things headed your way. So our next auction will be Saturday at 10 a.m. here at our auction gallery. You can bid live or online. That is all from a decorator's warehouse in out of Kentucky. We went down to Kentucky and picked up a whole truckload, and there's a lot of decorative items, furniture, a lot of odd chairs and cast iron, some antiques, and just you know, if you're a decorator, please view our website. We're currently working on the estate of this fellow was a racing enthusiast, and he was a photographer, and we've got thousands and tens of thousands of photographs of a midget car, sprint car, NASCAR, IndyCar, photo albums, programs, just a large collection of racing coming to you. A lot of things from IRP and the Speedrome. Really cool. Today we found an album of photos from the 1920s and 30s Fort Wayne and Kokomo, little local racetracks, some really neat stuff coming your way. So please pay attention to the website. We've got a large estate coming that'll take us a couple auctions to get liquidated in March. That came to us out of Indianapolis. We've got trucks and trailers, and just about all of our warehouses are full right now. So we've got a lot of auctions coming your way, and we look forward to conducting an auction for you. If you have things that you need to sell, turn into cash, liquidate, we do estate auctions and senior downsizing. We do farm sales. We do real estate auctions. If you have business assets, collector cars, fleet vehicles, antique tractors, coins, jewelry, artwork, antiques, we sell the ground and everything on it, and we love what we do, and we want to do it for you. That's right. I've been an auctioneer for 28 years now, and we just love to sell stuff to people. It's what we do. We enjoy it. We're enthusiastic about the items that we're selling. And we want to sell for you. So we appreciate each and every one of you being with us, participating in the auction. We will have some live auctions coming up. If you miss those and want to attend live auctions, just bookmark burgessauctions.com. Get on our email list. We send out a weekly email about the auctions that are coming up. And, we're on Auction Zip and Burgess Auctions. Follow us. Like us on Facebook. We've been doing a bat joke of the day. And we do appreciate your comments. We're getting ready to start a bat joke of the day contest where, you guys can submit your bat jokes and we'll have people vote on them and maybe award a little prize or something for that. So, we just, we enjoy visiting with people and seeing you. We miss seeing everybody at our live auctions, but we do sure enjoy visiting with you when you come to pick up or drop off or stop in to preview the auctions. We're always open for previews. So, lots of good old country decor coming up. Over about 400 lots left in this auction, so it'll be wrapping up maybe 8:30 or so. Just please visit burgessauctions.com. When the auction's over, about 20 or 30 minutes after the auction's over, we'll send out invoices if you're a winning bidder, and then you'll receive a text message to schedule your pickup appointment tomorrow. We are here from 9 to 5 all day tomorrow. So if you sign up for a time slot, we'll have your order ready when you get here and get you on your way real quick. So make sure that you ask to preview the next auction while you're here tomorrow. I think it'll be pink stickers will be the Saturday auction. So just tell them you want to see the pink stuff, and you'll be welcome to preview while you're here. So we do appreciate each and every one of you, and I'm going to go ahead and sign off for now. I will tell you that we have a firearms auction coming up in March. I don't know the exact date now, but we are licensed federal firearm dealers. So if you have firearms collections that you need to sell, just give us a call and we'd be happy to visit with you and see how we can help. That's one of the things that we enjoy most about our business is, helping people in times of need. So, well, I do appreciate each and every one of you. And don't forget to bookmark burgessauctions.com. And we will see y'all later.